we cannot directly create work objects. We cannot directly create work objects under the abstract class. See, if you want to create the work objects, means compulsory we need to go for the concrete class. And see, coming to the concrete class, so already told you, so for the first abstract class, so when the first abstract class is created, means at the time of organization setup, at the time of organization setup, what are the top level class which is automatically created? So that is called as the first abstract class. So what are the top level class created at the time of organization setup? The top level class is nothing but a abstract class. We can also call the top level classes abstract class. And abstract class names ends with hyphen. So what are the class name we have given for that abstract class? It class names ends with hyphen. And at the same time, for the first abstract class, it is derived from the first abstract class is derived from @ base class, or we can also say the parent class for the first abstract class is @ base class. So this is about the abstract class. So normally, while creating the class structure in our application, means while giving the class name to that application, normally, so we can also directly, we can also see there will be, so 3 to 2 to 3 ways will be there. Some cases we can directly use the concrete class, or in some cases we can create our class structure with two names, and some cases we can also create the class structure with three names, and also with single name also we can create the class structure. So that one I will tell you. So we can directly use the concrete class for creating the class structure, or else if we use the two names, means see, for example, if you are using one name, means so we can give the class name like this, for example OLX app. If you are taking a single name, means so the class name we can provide like this. For example, if you are providing two names for your class, at that time we can give the name as OLX hyphen. So this OLX hyphen will be the abstract class, and this abstract class we are using whenever, so what are the top level class is created at the time of organization setup, the same class name we are using at the time of class creation. So again, there is no need to create this abstract class. So we will reuse the same class which is created at the time of organization setup. Now directly enter the concrete class name. So I will tell you, first of all I will tell you about concrete class. So concrete classes means, so these classes are initialized classes. And we can directly create work objects under concrete class. We can directly create the work objects. So how we can create work objects, means for that there is one parent class is there. So for that we have to provide one parent class. So that parent class name is, for the first concrete class, for the first concrete class we should provide the parent classes, or we can say the first concrete class is derived from work hyphen. In yesterday's session I already told you work hyphen is one of the subclass of @ base class. So whenever we are creating the first abstract class, we will give the parent class. So actually, for this OLX hyphen, automatically it will created in the back end. Suppose if you are manually creating the abstract class, means at the time we have to give the parent class as a grade base class. So I will also show you how to manually create this abstract class. So here it is automatically created. In this case there is no need to manually provide this class name. Automatically in the back end it will take the class name as the parent class name as a grade base class. But for the first concrete class we have to manually give the class name as work-hyphen. So whenever we are creating our first concrete class, its parent class will be, or it is derived from the class called work-hyphen. So just remember this point. So for the first abstract class, at the grade base class, and for the first concrete class, work-hyphen will be the parent class. And this class name can be created in so different ways. So these are the three ways we can create the class. So normally in some companies they will directly use a single name, and some companies uses two names, and some companies uses three names. Suppose if we use the single name, we can give a name like this, and this class will be directly concrete class. So when we give a single name, this class will be concrete class. So directly we will give a class name, and the type we should select, the class type we should select as concrete here. So that one I will show you. So at the time of creation I will show you the difference. Suppose if you are giving two names for your class, so class means here nothing but class structure. So what are the class I am saying is, class is nothing but class structure. So already told you, we'll have different names for the class structure. It is also called as class group, or we can also call it as work pool. So these are the three names. So all the three names are similar only. So but in different scenarios we are going to use different names in different places. If we give two names, means see, the combination will be abstract and concrete. So OLX hyphen is abstract class, and whenever we are creating our first concrete class, so that will be our total class group. For example, OLX hyphen app. So if you are using two names, means this OLX hyphen is abstract class, and app class is, app is a concrete class, and this total class will be our class structure. So this, if you are using two names, means abstract plus concrete. So and this total we used to call it as class group. If you directly take a single class, means so this also will be the class group only, because in the, while creating the concrete class, so there will be types will be there. So in the concrete class, so there are three types of classes is there. So one is class group, belongs to class group, and does not belongs to class group. So automatically whenever we create our first concrete class, so that class type will be is a class group. So here also automatically whenever we create our first concrete class, so the class type will be is a class group. Similarly, if you are using three names, for example I am taking OLX hyphen online hyphen, so this first class is abstract class, and I'm online hyphen also I'm taking as abstract class, and this third class name I'm taking as a concrete class. So here whenever we create our first concrete class, then this total class will be your class structure. So why? Because I will tell you. So at the time of concrete class creation, so there will be option. So automatically, so we have to select the class type as is a class group. So means this total OLX hyphen online hyphen app will be our class group name. So then what, this total belongs to concrete only. So all this total OLX hyphen online hyphen app will become a concrete class. So like this, in different ways we can create. So here the first class is abstract, the second class is also abstract, and third class concrete class. and this total we used to called as is a class group. So like this we can create the class in three different ways. So this is about the concrete class. So once again I'm repeating. So abstract, so class structure will be a combination of abstract class and concrete classes. So either we can directly create a concrete class or we can create the class structure with the combination of abstract class also. So why I'm saying, so if we take single class means, so how it will become a concrete class you can ask. So how it will become a class structure you can ask. So because, so what is the parent class we are giving for the first concrete class? Automatically, so this work-fn will be the abstract class only. So automatically this abstract class means, so which is part of the @ base class, because already I told you @ base class contains some subclasses like work-fn, data-fn and history-fn. So automatically when we, if you use a single name, so even that class is deriving from the abstract class only. So this abstract class name is work-fn. So even if you use two names also, so just we are using that name. So for our class name we are just using the name called olx hyphen here. So this is two names, right? Sorry, this is the, so with two names olx hyphen we are using that abstract class name, and directly I'm taking a class called app which is a concrete class. So here the simple logic is, whenever we are creating our first concrete class, then the total class will be, then the total class will be our class group or class structure, or we can also call it as work pool. Now we will create a class. So yesterday for creating a new class we have temporarily selected one default class called Pegasample. So from that Pegasample now we will create our own class. So first of all I will create with a single name. So later I will another example I will take two names, and in another example I will take three names. So we will work out on all these things. So first of all, so we have taken in the previous session, so when we log in with our operator ID system architect @ olx.com. So the password for that is rules is the password. So once after logging this operator ID, so we have selected option called Pegasample, means use existing work pool we have selected. So use existing work pool means, so for creating a new class we have to temporarily select one class called Pegasample. So after that what I did, so I think I did not done that thing, I think. So again, first system architect olx.com. So don't worry, don't bother about these things. So all this class setup will be done by the, so administrators or business analysts. So all this configuration will be done. So while you, so login, so what are the operator ID you are logging with, so already this configuration will be created itself. So no need to worry about this class structure and organization setup. So just remember, so only one point, so when they ask you about the what is the class structure in your application, so just tell the for example if any app, for example olx app is there, means you can give the class name with two names. So for example this is my class name, and so this is the main class group. So after that if there is any subclasses in your application, so you can explain about the subclasses and you can explain the hierarchy, so from where this class is inherited. So automatically, so every class will be derived from the @ base class. So that is the, so top level super class. So from that only, so all the class groups will be so inherited. So later I will show the hierarchy of these classes. So what is the top level, so what are the subclasses, so all those things. So when we log in for the first time using that operator ID system architect, so here the two options are create new application and use existing work pool. So click on this use existing work pool. It will open a page here. So this page is access group page. So access group is nothing but here we can do two things. One is whenever we are want to change the class structure, or we can say whenever we want to change the work pool, at that time we will go to this option. So one second. And another thing is, so in order to change the role of the particular operator, suppose if a system architect is there, if you want to change the role of that system architect, so means giving the access to the particular operator, so like whether it is business analyst or whether it is so administrator or whether he is developer, so all those permissions we can give from the access group here. So access group means, so based on the role in our organization, so we can select the different roles. So but we will not get in the system architect, so we can do this from the administrator operator ID. So administrator @ so olx.com. so from there, so all these roles can be given. So but we will not get in this system architect operator ID. So normally from the access group option we can change the work pool. So that is one more point. So what I am doing is, I am temporarily using one existing class for creating a new class. So already in every Pega software, so the default work pool is Pega sample. So suppose if you want to create a new class, so for your application, at that time we can select the default class called Pega sample, then save this. After saving this, in order to reflect in the left pin, we have to log out from this operator ID, and again we have to re-log in. If you want to reflect here, we have to log off and log in. So this is the default one. From here we have to create our own class. So first of all, I will create a class with single name. So classes, if you want to create a new class, so from which category we have to create means, so under the system admin category, or we can also call as sysadmin category. So go to this option. So there we will have an option called class option. So from here we can create our new class. So for this new class, I want to give a class name called OLX app. So I want to give the class name as this. So right click on this class name.